Hey folks, thanks for coming in and joining me here at Tree Chat for another video. So today I want to grow one of the most commonly grown trees you're going to find in New Zealand, and that is the Manuka. Nurseries everywhere growing it, growing heaps of it, doing a great job, perfect for revegetation and everything. But anyway, I thought I'll grow some myself, show you guys how I do it. I bet there's heaps of amazing methods out there, but this is what's worked for me. So I'm out here. First thing we're going to do is just identify our tree to make sure it's a Manuka or a Kanuka. Easy way there is Manuka is mean, the leaves are spiky, Kanuka is kind, so they're soft. So this is my specimen here, I'm just going to check the leaves. Yeah, they're spiky, so we know this is a Manuka. Next thing I do, I'm going to grab some of the seeds. So come with me, we'll have a closer look and I'll show you what to look for. Alright team, so the seeds are contained in these little pods. So here's a bunch here on this branch. Hopefully they're showing up nicely. We want to look for the ones that are still closed up. So what happens, they get ripe, the seed pods open, the seeds spill out and the wind just disperses them. So we want to get them before that stage. So these guys here in the frame now look pretty perfect to me. You can see that it's almost got like a star pattern on them. You can see it's quite tightly closed, which is perfect. That means the seeds are still inside. Now, if we look at these guys here, hopefully they're in focus, you can see they're open. So there's no more seeds in there. So we don't need those, or we don't want those because there's no seeds. So gonna be pretty useless, but you can see there's plenty of pods here which are still closed, which is exactly what we are after. Okay, folks, I've got a plastic bag to grab our seed pods in. I'm just going to go ahead and pick a bunch of these closed capsules, whack them in my bag, and then we'll go home and do the rest. But anyway, just picking these off. Into the bag. Hopefully you can see that, guys, but you can see that it's not a huge seed capsule, so it doesn't look big, but I can tell you that once it opens, there's a heap of seed inside there because the seed is very small and fibrous, almost looks kind of like a red saffron. So yeah, not a big pod, but there is going to be a heap of seed inside there, which you'll see. So we don't need heaps, but I'm going to grab enough to do sort of one seed tray, hopefully. Okay team, well I've got my seed capsules here now in my overly large Ziploc bag, but there's about 70 odd capsules in there, I think, and I reckon that's going to be more than enough for one seed tray. But you'll see when they open just what I mean by how much seed comes out of one capsule. So yeah, so that's our seed collected. Next phase, I'm going to go home and I'll show you the next steps, so let's go. Okay team, back at base camp now with our seed capsules. Next part of the process is really super easy. We just gotta wait for the capsules to open and the seeds to fall out. So I'm just gonna take them out of this plastic bag. We don't wanna leave them in there. Pop them in a paper bag, or in this case, an envelope. And then I'm just gonna leave them somewhere warm for probably about a week. I'll just check every couple of days, see how they're going. Capsules will just ripen, dry up and open, and the seeds will just fall out. They're collected in our paper bag. Simple as that, that's the next step. So that's that seed capsule all in here now, and I'm just going to pop them over there behind you guys on my workbench. It's warm in the shed here, so yeah, it won't take too long for these guys to dry and split open now, and then we can get on to sowing the seed. Well team, just like that, 1 week's gone by and I can confirm that things are looking excellent in our seed capsule envelope. So let's come in, take a closer look. Well, here we go folks. There's the contents of our envelope. We've got our seed capsules which have opened quite nicely. And you can see
underneath them there's a whole bunch of fine seed. So I'm going to tip this out. Let's have a closer look on this paper here. Hopefully you guys can see this pretty good. So wow, yeah, there's a heap of seed there. So we've got our capsules and all this fine fibrous stuff here is the seed, and it's, yeah, I think I'd liken it to a saffron fiber. Very small. And as far as the capsules go, they're all open. So you remember before they were closed up in that star pattern. Now they're open, all the seeds falling out. Pretty much all of these are done, I think. Which is kind of academic because you can see how much seeds there. That's more than enough. So let's get on to the next step and get this sown. Righto folks, time for sowing. Got all my usual suspects here. If you've seen any of my other videos, I'm going to use the same method as I pretty much use for most of my natives. So we need a seed tray for everything to go in. Piece of perspex to go on the top at the end. Got my seed here. Then I've got a standard potting mix and a seed raising mix. Right. Step one team, we're going to get a base of our standard potting mix. Probably about 2/3 of the seed tray. That's good like that. Next step, top up with some seed raising mix on the top. Just going to give that a bit of a tap down first. Make sure it's a nice firm base for our seed to grow in. And I'm also going to give that a quick bit of a water because this potting, this seed raising mix has got really dry. So, righto, so this mix is nice and moist now. Quite firm down. Now we need to get our seed involved. And there's so much of it. Honestly, there's thousands of seed in there. Obviously we don't need thousands of trees, but hey, let's give it a go, see how many come up. We can always thin them out later. So I'm just going to scatter them over, just broadcast it, and try and get an even coverage. Because obviously if we get lots clumped in one spot, that's not great. Okay, I reckon that'll do us. So I haven't sowed them all. That was probably about half, I guess. They do tend to germinate really well, so I reckon we're going to get a good strike with a bit of luck, fingers crossed. It is St. Patrick's Day today, so luck of the Irish surely. Right, so that seed's in. Now I'll just give it a bit of a cover, really fine covering of the seed raising mix on top. You barely want it to be covered at all. Can still see some of the seed. I want to just be able to see it, or just being able to start not being able to see it, if that makes any sense at all. Okay, that's probably good. And then a bit more water on the top, squeezy bottle again, make sure it's nice and moist in there. Okay guys, that's pretty much that part done. All I'm going to do now is pop my perspex on top. Literally just sits on top like that. I'm going to pop this whole thing in a nice shady spot, somewhere warm, though, and nice and sheltered. And we'll come back in, I think, probably no more than 2 weeks. And hopefully we're going to see a bunch of Manuka popping up. Again, fingers crossed. So yeah, see you soon. Hey folks, so welcome back. It's been 6 weeks since I last chatted to you, and happy to confirm we have some good Manuka action going on in our tray here. So these guys did start germinating about 2 weeks or so, or just before 2 weeks after I sowed them. So that was really good, right on schedule. I took a quick video at 18 day mark. I'll just show you that right now. Okay, cool. So that was those little guys there at 18 day mark. Obviously 6 weeks now, so they have grown up a bit. Probably about 20 mil high by now. So let's come in and I'll show you guys a closer look at what's going on here. Every little sprout you're seeing there is a tiny Manuka. So we've had an awesome strike on our seed here. Lots have germinated. And they have been in a shady spot. So now you can see they're getting a little bit stalky. So I do need to pop them somewhere with a bit more light so they can grow more naturally, because Manuka love light. They don't like shade once they've grown up a bit. So that'll be my next step. Okay team, so successful so far. We've got a tiny Manuka. So what I'm gonna do is, I said I'll pop them into some bit more light, let them grow up a bit. And obviously they can't keep growing in this tray forever, so we're gonna need to prick them out. So once they get to, I would say about 40 mil high, we're gonna start pricking them out of this tray, each individual seedling into a bigger space where it can grow. In this case, I have these 50T cell trays. So we're gonna fill these with potting mix, and every cell is gonna have one Manuka. So I'm gonna pick out one Manuka from here into each cell. Obviously 50 per tray. Now, process for pricking out, I'm just gonna use my normal process, which you can see in this link here, which is the same process I use for pretty much all my native trees. They do say that Manuka can be quite sensitive as far as their roots go when pricking out. So I'm inclined to prick these out a bit sooner than I would other species. So yep, I'll prick those out into these trays, obviously let them grow bigger, and probably in around a year's time, they'll be ready to plant out and yeah, grow and do their thing. So thanks for watching everyone, as always. Good luck on your germination. Happy growing.